Does OpenAI's new O3 model work well with enterprise content? I'm Alex Novotny, Senior Developer Advocate here at Box. Let's take a look. So I have three examples for you today. The first one we're going to look at is metadata. If you aren't familiar, Box metadata is very powerful. It allows you to attach specific information about a file. That way you can use it in third-party processes or other systems. So if we take a look at this invoice, for example, you can click on the little M metadata button on the right side. And you can see a place to add metadata templates. I've actually already made one for this specific demo, and you make them in the admin console. And it just looks like this. You add a name for it, and you add different fields. There's fields like text, date, single select, number, multi-select. And if you go into the metadata option, I can actually select that specific template that I've made. And we recently released, as part of eAdvanced, the ability to autofill. So like if I click autofill, it will use that template as well as the data in the invoice to then select different bits of information that it thinks belongs there, and then you can edit and save it. The cool thing, you can also do the same functionality with the Box AI API, and that's what we're going to take a look at now. So over here in the code, I have a method that goes and calls our Box AI extract structured method, and I simply give it the template key of the metadata template that I already created, and I'm using the O3 model, which is what this ID is, and if I send it off, it returns back the information that you saw on the front end, right? It's the same information. It identified the invoice state. It identified the invoice ID. Where this becomes even more powerful is if you can run this across multiple invoices. For example, in this folder, I have a lot of invoices. I have 10. What if I wanted to extract the metadata from all of them and then also go ahead and apply it? That's what this next method does. And again, in this method, I'm just sending in the specific invoice template key that I created already, and then it applies the metadata that it finds to the files themselves. So let's run this, and then we'll go back and check if it did it correctly. So looking at the result, it looks like it did grab metadata for all of the files, and it looks like it applied it. Let's take a look in Box and see if it worked. So I'll open up one of these invoices. And if I go to the metadata tab, it did. So if we look, the vendor name looks like Superstore, which is correct. And the balance total amount is due is right. This one didn't have taxes, which is what the empty values means. Let's look at another one. This one did have taxes. So cool. So what this did was processed, what is this, almost 10 invoices in one go, used Box AI to extract the metadata with the OpenAI O3 model. And you would want to use the API for this. One, you can't do multiple files currently natively in Box through the front end. You need to do it using the API, or you'd, you know, need to go one off. And then when metadata gets attached on a file, you can then use it in a subsequent process. So this can trigger something like a Box relay workflow. It can connect to something like Salesforce, and you can then take that data and use it down the line. So for the next example, I want to look at photos. If you aren't familiar, Box AI can analyze photos. I have three different photos here that are totally different. One is of a person. One is of a car, just on a road. And one is of a plane. Going to the code, this method, I'm using our multi-item QA, so you can ask questions about multiple items, right? And I'm asking, are any of these photos of a plane? And if there is one, what kind of plane is it? So looking at the response, it says yes. It even tells me the second photo is the plane. So looking at the file ID, which is 161, we do see that that actually was the second photo. So that's really cool that it even identified that piece. And it says it's an old wooden biplane displayed indoors, likely in a museum setting. I mean, that's really cool, right? Because then you could look at a photo. Let's say you had, like, I don't know, 25 of these photos of different planes. Maybe you wanted to look at a specific type of plane or something else on the plane. Is the plane yellow? You could do this programmatically as part of some other process using the Box AI API and then take that information and do something else with it. Really cool.